Hey there, hello. The premise of this video is pretty straightforward. We're gonna make a summary statistic table using Stata. So let's just look at the data set first. We're gonna start out here in Excel. If you have a small data set or medium-sized data set, then Excel is perfectly fine to use. If you have a big data set, then Excel and this video in general isn't really for you. So here is the data set. We have three variables. We have a height, presumably in centimeters. We have IQ, and we have wage, and the currency here, not quite sure. And we have two different groups. So the thing here is that this data here is just random. I just generated it with your pseudo random numbers. So the data is not real. It doesn't mean anything, but it will serve our purpose here, I suppose. So data set with three variables and an additional variable which describes two different groups, group one and group two. So two things to notice here is the name of the workbook and the name of the worksheet. Now the workbook is like the entire Excel spreadsheet. And in this case, I decided just to call it data set, capital D, capital S. And also notice here that the name of the worksheet is just the default one, sheet one. We could name it something else, but this is the name I'm using right now, and it's important because we need to know these two names when you're going to import the dataset from Excel. Before we jump over to Stata, I'm going to show you what the final output is going to look like. It's going to look a little bit something like this. We're going to have a table here, and we can be interested in any kind of summary statistics, but just for the purpose of illustration here, I'm interested in the mean, the standard deviation, the skewness, the kurtosis, and the number of observations. And I want to know this both for like the both of this group pooled together when they're aggregated, and also want to know the statistics for each individual group, for group one and group two. So what this different group represents, we don't know. Again, it's just a randomly simulated data set. So let's jump over to Stata here. This is what Stata looks like. If you want to write some code, you can write one line at a time here in the command line interface, but that's not really efficient. So what you want to do is to open up the do editor, where you can write in like a script. So you can write do edit, and you can run that, and it will open up something that looks like Notepad. Now I already done that, and I already typed in the code because it's boring to watch me type it with many mistakes. So here is the entire code. It looks a little bit intimidating, but it's actually really quite straightforward. Once you've done this a few times, this is like intuitive by nature. You don't really need to think all that much about it. So first order of business is that I want to clear everything away. Start this like a kitchen bench. We need to clean away, make the kitchen bench clean before we can start making a new meal. So clear all, we'll do that. Get rid of everything old. Set more off. That will, by default, Stata will interrupt a loop once the screen, this screen at least, when that is filled, and you need to click the space bar in order to continue. And that is quite annoying when you're gonna use loops, which is gonna be an integral part of this script. So I'm just gonna turn that off. Now it says permanently, but it will be back on again if you close your Stata and open it up again. Next order of business, I want to change the directory to where my Excel file is stored. So it is stored in the folder on the C drive, on users, Cinder, that's me, under documents, in a folder called Stata Summary Statistics. That's where I have the Excel spreadsheet. This one over here is stored in that folder. Let's see. And then I'm going to import it. Import Excel using the name of the Excel spreadsheet, dataset.xlsx. As you might remember from over here, it's just called dataset. So whatever the name is, that's what we need to specify in the Stata code. And then comma, we specify the name of the sheet, like a workbook and many sheets, and they can have different names. So if you have more than one, you need to kind of specify which one it is. And then also we put in the option here, first row. That means that the very first row is going to be the name of the variable and not an observation itself. So we can just highlight this and click Control D for delta or D for do, I suppose. And we get the data in here. If I want to look at the data that we just imported, we can write browse or you can shorten that to just bro. And here it is. It looks as it should. If the numbers here were red, that would be an indication that we did something wrong. Specifically, that would mean that we are mixing together numeric values and text. So it all becomes interpreted as a string. So if I want to do summary statistics on a variable, that's pretty straightforward. I can write summarize and then the name of the variable, for instance, height. If I do that, we get an output here, a summary statistics table. The problem with this summary statistics table is that it's very limited. It only gives us the number of observations, the mean, the standard deviation, the min, and the max. But as you might remember, I was also interested in having the skewness and kurtosis. So this summary statistics command, as we just did it, is not sufficient. I need to do more. And luckily, I can just write there, comma, detail. And will give me more, well, details, as the syntax suggests. So now we get the previous numbers, the observation, mean, standard deviation, min and max. But we also get like the percentiles, here's the median, for instance. We get the variance, the skewness, and kurtosis. So we got a little bit more summary statistics here. So if I want to look at one particular group, need to remember how we organize the data. So the height and IQ and weight is just listed down here, and then we have an additional variable here, which is like group 1, group 2. So how would I be able to look at only one specific group, like group 2, for instance? Well, that's pretty straightforward. We can put in an if condition there. So summarize height if group. No, I don't need to actually spell out things there. So once I write gr in here, I can just click tab and we'll autocomplete. So if group is equal to double equal sign, and my keyboard is in the wrong language. Sorry about that. So if group is equal to 2, for instance, we can run that. And then we get slightly different numbers. So for instance, when we looked at both group 1 and group 2, we got a mean of 171. Looking only at group 2, we get a mean of 178. So that's how you can do conditional summary statistics. Now, another problem with the summary statistics table is that what are you supposed to do with this output? It's just here in the Stata window. It would be extremely tedious if you had to do the summary statistics for each of the variables for both of the groups, group 1, group 2. So that would be 3 times 3, so that would be 9 times you would need to run this summarize command. And then you would need to copy paste here. Let's see how many numbers they want. I wanted 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 9 times 5. So 45 numbers you would have to sit here, right click and copy. Like that is not feasible. That is that would be too tedious and too prone to errors. So that's why we would like to make a script there. So the first order of business is to kind of realize how exactly you extract the numbers that are displayed here on the screen. So Stata doesn't really tell you this, but most of the output, or pretty much all of the output, with a few exceptions that you see here in the Stata window, is stored in two different lists. One is called the return list, and another one is called the e-return list. So for the summarize, the summary statistics command, all of this data is stored in the return list. So if I write here, return list, we will see exactly how we can reference each of the numbers in the table. So for instance, as you can see here, the mean is 178.5923. And you can see it actually comes from here, R mean. So if I, for instance, write display, then R mean, then here we have the number. So this number I can export somewhere else. I could export it to Excel, for instance, by using the put Excel command. So I can do any kind of things. I can display the number, I can do math with it, such as this. So this is how we extract the numbers. So I don't want to export one number at a time to Excel. As I said, that's going to be 45 numbers. That's kind of tedious. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take all of these 45 numbers, put them in a matrix, and then I'm going to export the whole matrix over to Excel. because it's a bit time consuming to actually export things to Excel, not that much, but it's more efficient if we gather up all the information that we want to export and then export it all in one go. So that is essentially what the script is going to do. So once we have imported the data, we can run the rest of the script like this and just control D. So let me just explain what's going on there. First, I have made a variable called myvar, in Stata, you can't just write x equals 2. That doesn't work. You need to write local. And often the equal sign is implied. You don't actually need to write it either, unless there's some kind of function. If it's just a number or name or word, then this is sufficient. So myvar contains the variables I want to run the summary statistic on, height, IQ, and wage. So what I basically want to do is to make a foreach loop where I run the summary statistics. So foreach var in myvar. And if I want to reference a variable that I defined with local here, I need to write these brackets, these single quotation marks. First the slope, the curved one, and then the straight one. It's a little bit confusing, but this is pretty standard in Stata. So I'm just going to demonstrate to you how this loop would work. So display var. So the thing, another thing about Stata variables using local is that you cannot define them, then use them later on. You need to define them and use them in the same go, in the same snippet. So just running this snippet wouldn't work. I need to run both snippets at the same time. So as you can see here now in the output window, I did a foreach loop. So looping through all the values of myvar, I just want to display it. So we get height, IQ, and wage. So what you can imagine that I'm going to do here is essentially that I want to run the summary statistics command. I'm going to summary statistics on the var variable, comma detail. So something like that. So you're going to run the code like three times here. And then go three more times, these three times, because I want both groups and then each group. So that's how the foreach loop works. So before I actually run the loop, which starts down here, I need to create an empty matrix where I'm going to place these 45 different numbers. So I'm going to create a matrix. So I'm going to call it result. So matrix called result is going to be equal to a matrix with five columns. And currently the value is going to be empty. There's going to be no value in them at all. I'm going to populate it later on with the foreach loop. And how many rows are there going to be? Well, it's going to be the number of variables, and it's going to be multiplied by 3, because as I said, I want both groups and then each group. So that's 3 times. So 3 times number of variables. Now, I could just hard code here and say 9 as right, or say 3 times 3, but I kind of want to make this script dynamic. So I'm actually using a function up here to count how many variables or many words there are in the variable myvar. So local word count, colon, word count, and then just the variable here. So this will be equal to 3. It's going to count here. Okay, here's my var. And there's one word, two word, three words. And then I'm going to give this the columns in this empty matrix some names. And that I'm going to have to hard code. And I call it mean, standardization, skewness, kurtosis, and n, which is number of observations. So before we proceed to populate this matrix, I thought we can just display it and see what it looks like. So at the bottom here, matrix list result. I'll just copy paste this up here for the time being. So if we run this snippet of code, we get the output. So we get five columns there with the hard-coded column names, mean, standard deviation, skewness, kurtosis, and n. And for the time being, we have 9 different rows that just have the default name R1, R2, R3, all the way to R9. As you can see here, they don't have any values. They just have the dot, which in Stata just means there is nothing in there. It's just empty. So to populate it, we're going to do a foreach loop. As I said, we're going to loop through each variable. That is going to be representing each of the rows. So one iteration in the foreach loop is one variable, one row. And within a particular row, we're gonna, for each of the columns, we are going to put in some values. So for the first column, we have the mean. To get that, we take our mean, put that into result, where we specify the row number and the column number. Column number is hard-coded here, but the row number is gonna be come from here, local row one. And for each iteration of this loop, we're gonna increment row by one. So for each iteration, this is gonna have a value of one, then it's gonna have a value of two, and three, and so on and so forth, for all three variables. And also here, we have a little trick here to we're making a list here that just contains the variable name. So this is gonna be used later on to get the row names of this output matrix, this matrix to call result. So all the way down here, we say that matrix row names for the matrix called result is gonna have the row names from this variable called row n, short for row name, and that is defined up here incrementally. So we do this once here, and this is basically gonna be for when you look at both groups together, so running summary statistics, no conditions. And then I copy paste this snippet of code and pasted it down here, but I made a few minor changes. I've wrapped it inside a forval loop. So that's a loop here, forval I equals 1 to 2. So this is going in the first iteration, I is gonna have a value of 1, and the second iteration, I is gonna have a value of 2. And that is important because when you run summary statistics here, you put in the condition, if, let's see, group is equal to I. So if group is equal to 1, or if group is equal to 2. And again, the rest is basically the same. So if you run all of this, if you run this, then we get here in Stata, we get the output, we get this matrix now. So height, IQ, wage, and that repeats again. So for the first three rows, that's gonna be for both groups. Then you're gonna have for group number 1, and then you're gonna have for group number 2. So the specific values here, they don't really matter because this is just randomly simulated data. So the final thing we need to do here is to output this into Excel. And that we can do down here. So I make a variable called fileName, which is gonna have the name of the of where I'm gonna output it, summary statistics. Then I need to initialize this, so put Excel set, fileName, modify. And then in column C, row 5, or cell C5, I'm gonna output this matrix that's called result, and I'm gonna also add the names, the row names and the column names. So if we do that, we are gonna end up with this in Excel. So this is not quite what we had in Word, but this is basically all we need. So what you can do is just copy paste it over, and then you can do some minor formatting on your own. You can, for instance, make this bold. You can add the borders, such as this, for instance. Like that. Let's see. We can make this bold. What you can do, we can also add some additional space there, such as this. Let's see, we can merge. This was for both groups. You can underline that, make it bold. And then there was the group one. This is group number 1, and then similarly for group number 2, you can copy paste this, so this will be group number 2, and it's common to have a border at the bottom here, and the exact style and format will depend on which style you're following, but something like this is usually acceptable. Then you should have some kind of table description at the bottom, which is aligned here to the left, and then usually up here you just have the table number, so table 1, summary, statistics. So you do have to do a little bit of formatting in Excel. You might also want to change the number of decimals here. 2 decimals is probably sufficient. like this. And then it's just a matter of selecting it and copy pasting it into Word, which is already done there. We can do it again. There we go. And then you can perhaps put it in the center, or you can, let's see, table design here. You can auto fit it depending on the width and length, that sort of things. So long story short, that's how you could make a summary statistics table. Just to summarize, we started with some data here. We get it into Stata by using import Excel. Then we did a loop here. The core of the loop is the summary statistics function. And in the end, we output it. So just to show the code there, I'm gonna slowly scroll through it. So this is how you could make a summary statistics table. Pretty straight forward, looks maybe a little bit intimidating at first glance, but nothing extraordinary going on here.